joining us for today's webinar. My name is Rakshit Thakur, working as a lecturer in Aeronautical Engineering Department, CIITTS, at Parel University. Today we are presenting a webinar titled as Aerodynamics of Turbo Machines, presented by Professor Jignesh Gwala, sir. Just a little housekeeping before we get started. So if you have any questions during the presentation, please type them to my number. Please write down my number 9426432946. I'm repeating again. It's 9426432946. I'll bring them up during the presentation and we will also have a time for question at the end. Now, without a further ado, we will turn the time over to Professor Jignesh Gwala, sir. He is the presenter and he is working as the assistant professor in the Department of Aeronautical Engineering, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Institute of Technology at Vassar. He did his Master of Engineering in the field of jet propulsion and gas turbine plants from the Faculty of Technology, MS University, Baroda. He is holding a bachelor degree in Aeronautical Engineering from SVIT Vassar. He has 8 years of teaching experience and 1 year of industrial experience. Professor Gwala sir has published 17 research papers in national and international journals and conferences. He has guided many students for their undergraduate research projects. He has organized one national conference and 3 SOP. His area of research are aerodynamics, CFD, that is computational fluid dynamics, unmanned aerial vehicles, propulsion, turbo machinery. He is also currently pursuing his PhD. So now, without delay, I invite
Yes, thank you very much, Professor Rakshit sir. Such a very nice introduction by you. Thank you very much, sir. So without wasting time, I'll start my presentation. So am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Fine, thank you. Yeah. So good morning to one and all present here. And today we will be discussing that's regarding the aerodynamics of turbo machines. So aerodynamics and turbo machine both are very important field in aerospace industries, in aeronautical industries. We can also say that the automobile industries, mechanical industry. Without turbo machinery, we cannot improve the aerodynamic efficiency. So we will discussing regarding the aerodynamics along with the turbo machines. So this is the very nice slide that put your seat belts on. The flight is taking off. So I'm going to start my lecture. So what do you mean by the aerodynamics? So first we understood the meaning of aerodynamics, and this aerodynamics, this is the Greek word. Fine. I hope you all of you the understood the meaning of air. With only the air properties that we can include the velocity, pressure, density, viscosity, right? So we are considering all these properties especially for the air. And dynamics means we will study about the motion of the air along with the interaction with a solid object. So whatever the flow passes over the body or the flow through the body, so we will observe the properties of air, and we can find it out. We can find it out all the properties. We can find it out the efficiency using the tool. Fine. So whatever the tool is there. So there are a lots of open source tools available in the market. So using any tool, we can find it out. Fine. So the aerodynamic, the physics behind the motion of air around an object is known as the aerodynamics. So the behavior of any object that moves through the air, that may be understood by the treating it with the tools and knowledge of aerodynamics. So this aerodynamic is very important toward in rotating equipment in turbo machinery field. So directly we will jump to the turbo machines. What do you mean by the turbo machines? Why the aerodynamic is very important, is very useful, or important properties of air in the part of rotating element? So first we understood the meaning of turbo machines. If we break out the word of turbo machines, so we can say turbo plus machines. So whatever we have the equipments, whatever we have the solid equipments or any blades, fine. So in turbo machines, this is a one device that exchanges the energy with a fluid using the continuously flowing fluid and rotating blades. So in turbo machines, we know the exchange of energy. This word is very important, the exchange of energy with the fluid. So in this case, we will deal with only the air. Why air? Because we are discussing about dynamics of turbo machines. So we are going to consider the air using the continuously flowing fluid and rotating blades. So here we can clearly see the aircraft is there. So there are lots of rotating elements. There are lots of rotating equipments inside this engine, inside this jet propulsion engine, that starting with, we can say, the axial fan is there, compressor is there, stator, rotor, the combination of stator and rotor, that we can say this is known as the first stage of turbine as well as first stage of compressor. Fine. And also we can say this rotating blades continuously moving with very high RPM. Fine. So this is the first example of turbo machines in our field, in our aerospace, in our aeronautical field. This is windmill. Fine. And look at the shape of the blade here. Okay. So this is one more example. Here we are using the aerodynamics in it. Okay. And suppose we have to improve the aerodynamic efficiency of this blade. So how can we improve it? So there are lots of physics we will consider, and that we can improve the efficiency. Fine. So there are lots of research work going on in turbo machine field, in rotating equipment field. And as I told you, this is known as the rotor blade. This we can clearly see here. This is the stator blade is also we can see here. And this is nothing but this is the Pelton blade. Fine. So this turbo machinery, this is the essential to the operation of modern world. And the turbines are used in all significant electricity that production throughout the world, in steam turbine power plant as well as the gas turbine power plant. And also we can say the hydroelectric power plant and the wind turbines. So pump are used to transport the water that municipal water system and in homes pumps. And the turbines are also essential in the transportation of fuel, oil and gas around the pipe network. So in real life application, this pump is also very important in turbo machinery field. Suppose we have to improve the efficiency of pump. So how can we improve it? Once again, we have to improve the aerodynamic efficiency. But how? We can change the blade angle, we can change the thickness, we can improve the hub to tip ratio, we can improve the impeller diameter, impeller blades, right? So once again, this is the R&D part. Fine. So this gas turbine engine that are used to power all large passenger in short turbo machinery in all around you. Fine. And this is the area of worthy for. And this is the very important application in industries of industries of aerospace. And what is the basic working principle of the turbo machines? This is very important. So the basic working principle of turbo machines, the overall working principle, that is high pressure. Fine. So high pressure stream is forced over blades attached to the shaft, which turn a generator. And we can say that the steam travel through the turbine. Fine. So this is passes through the smaller blades. Fine. So this passes the smaller blades, causing the shaft to spin faster, and this creating a more electricity. Okay. So this gas turbine works much like steam turbine. So this is the simple working principle of turbo machines in the field of gas turbine. We can say that what are the applications of turbo machines? Fine. So there are lots of applications of the turbo machines. So mainly that divided into the two main categories, that we can say the power producing and power absorbing. So the first category is used the preliminary to produce the power. Fine. So it includes, among others, the steam turbine, gas turbine, and the hydraulic turbine. Okay, and the main function of the secondary, that is increase a total pressure of working fluid by consuming the power. Okay, so the power producing machine and power absorb the machine. Fine. So mainly there are two main components, compressor and turbine. Fine. And the main basic components of turbo machines, that we can say the rotating element that carrying a vane operating in a stream of fluid. So whatever the fluid is, that we can say the air, water, fluid. So once again, it depends on the viscosity. It depends on our application. So which type of applications we have to use in the field of turbo machines. So based on it, we can use the different pumps. And the stationary element or elements that we generally act as a guide vanes or passages for the proper control of flow direction, and the energy conversion process is also very important. The input area, the input mass flow rate, the input area of the casing, this is also very important for that. So the rotating machinery is a machine with rotating component that transfer the energy to a fluid, or we can say vice versa. Fine. If the energy is from the fluid to the rotor, okay, so we have two different options: from the fluid to the rotor and rotor to the fluid. So then the machine is called a turbine. Okay, so if the energy transfer is from fluid to the rotor, is known as the turbine. Okay, same way we can say that the turbine to fluid is known as the compressor. Fine. So, but one question that going on in my mind, which type of turbo machinery is aerodynamically easy to design, compressor or turbine? Okay, without compressor, without turbine, we cannot drive this out. Fine. So in terms of design, aerodynamically design easier for what, compressor or turbine? Once again, question mark. Fine. So how can we say that this part is very easy for design purpose, this part is very complicated for the design purpose? So as a aeronautical engineer, we understood the basic principle of jet propulsion engine. Fine. So what happened inside the jet propulsion engine? So in it, air is sucked from the atmosphere. That what happened? Air is coming with some velocity, some mass flow rate of air. Fine. So what happened? There are lots of air particles coming from the atmosphere inside this engine and exit from the nozzle. Fine. But there are lots of process is going on inside the propulsive system. Okay. So these turbo machines play an important role in many parts of our life. One of them, aircraft, one of them, windmill, pump. Fine. So there are lots of examples for that. And these engines of almost all the modern aircraft or in the field of power generation. So there are the important component in process industries plant, and the very high demand are placed on efficiency, emission, and performance. Fine. So these three words are very important for the design point of view. Okay. And aerodynamics and structural mechanics of turbo machinery is a very important role in turbo machinery. So we must to understood the aerodynamics, we must to understood the structural mechanics. Without these two word, we cannot improve the efficiency. Okay. So in the addition of design of the thermodynamic cycle, the first we'll start with the thermodynamic cycle. So aerodynamics and turbo machines, right? So without thermodynamics, we cannot proceed. Okay. So there are you understood the first law of thermodynamics, the open system, closed system, isolated system, fine. So here we are using all this physics, and finally here we can very nice profile of PV diagram, right, where the pressure is situated in y axis, the velocity volume is situated in the x axis. So there are this is the ideal cycle, this is the actual cycle. So isothermal process is going on for this case, this is the adiabatic process, this is the isochoric process. So this is indicating from 1 to 2 dash is known as the PV ratio to gamma equal to constant. The another one, 1 to 2 double dash, is known as the PV equal to constant. The another one, 1 to 2 triple dash, is known as the PV ratio to infinity equal to constant. Fine. So this is the PV diagram. So the frictional profile, so the frictionless profile are considered using the potential flow theory, and on the basis of this approach, a basic understood of the profile design and the lift of individual profiles that should be conveyed. Okay, so on the basis of physics, on the basis of thermodynamics, we can apply the physics over it in compressor blade, in turbine. Fine. So the thickness of blade, curvature of the blade, the incidence angle, the profile thickness, hub to tip ratio, right? Which type of airfoil we are going to use for the case of propulsive system, for the case of fan, for the case of compressor, for the case of turbine. Fine. So we will deal with the number of blades. We will deal with the aerodynamic. So the important part is also TS diagram. Fine. So here we can clearly see the temperature is situated in y axis, S is situated in x axis. This is the K is nothing but that we can say the gamma, right? That we can say the ratio of Cp by Cv. Fine. So here this is the 1 to 2 dash is known as the isentropic process, and we know the meaning of isentropic process. The polytropic is known as 1 to 2, isothermal is known as the 1 to 2 double dash. Fine. The isochoric means the constant pressure, isothermal temperature remains constant. Fine. So this is the graph of compressor only. Fine. So in HS diagram, or we can say in TS diagram, T is a temperature, S is a entropy. Fine. So this ideal compression process is assumed to be here the isentropic, and deviation from this expression, this is known as the isentropic efficiency. And we know that this, for the case of compressor, the in TS diagram, 1/4 rotor and 1/4 stator. Okay, so what happened in compressor blade? We have a number of stages, like one blade of rotor, one blade of stator. So combination of R and S, combination of rotor and stator, is known as the first stage of compressor blade. Fine. So here we can say that this is ideal cycle, this is actual cycle, right? So 1-2-2 is known as the rotor blade, 2-2-3 is known as the stator blade. So what happened in rotor blade and what happened in stator blade, and what is the difference between rotor and stator blade shape, right? This is also very important. So whatever the losses form is known as X1. Here is known as the another loss in stator blade, X2. So here we can see X1 and X2 are the loss in the rotor and stator. Fine. So each and every component of fan, compressor, turbine, right? So losses are there. Okay. Without loss, we cannot drive this out. We cannot gain the energy. We cannot production of energy. Fine. So important role in this thermodynamics of compressor is very important static parameters like pressure, like velocity. This is very important. So as I told you, the shape of rotor and stator, so this is IGV. IGV is nothing but inlet guide vanes, right? The shape of IGV is like this. Then after the rotor blade is mount inside it. So look at this. This is a shape of rotor blade. This is a shape of diffuser blade. diffuser, or we can say stator. Both are same. Okay, but actually what happened when compressor drive, okay, air is sucked from the atmosphere. So what happened? Air is coming from the atmosphere to IGV, okay, inlet guide vane. So this inlet guide vane is to flow simply passes over it. So the main two parameters, pressure and velocity. So this is a chart of, or we can say this is a graph of pressure and velocity variation through a compressor stage. So what happened here? First, to reduce the pressure, slightly to reduce the pressure. And what happened? What is the relation between pressure and velocity? We know very well, both are opposite. Fine. So we can say here the pressure is reduced, slight, velocity remains, increases. But what happened after the IGV? Whenever the particle of air from atmosphere to IGV to rotor, so what happened in rotor? This is known as the leading edge part. This is known as the trailing edge part. Fine. So what happened here? Simply the air is coming from the IGV to rotor blade, from leading edge to trailing edge, proper chord length from here to here, the velocity remains higher. The velocity remains changed from leading edge to trailing edge. Parallelly, pressure is also varying. Okay. Why? Because of shape, because of profile, because of shape profile. Okay. Then after what happened? Due to the profile shape of diffuser blade, velocity suddenly, the value of velocity that suddenly decreases and value of pressure increases. What is our main aim in compressor blade? To rise the pressure, to rise the static pressure. We can achieve the maximum pressure at the end of first stage. Okay, this is a simple talk about the pressure and velocity variation through the compressor stage. Depend on our application, we can mount the different compressor stages. First stage, second stage, third stage, fourth stage, five stage, six stage. Suppose I am telling to you, six stage of compressor blade. Six stage means it has six blade of rotor and six blade of diffuser or stator. The combination of rotor and stator is known as the stage. Okay. So this is a simple talk regarding the pressure and velocity variation through the compressor stage. Okay. And based on the rotor and stator, based on the rotor blade and stator blade, this is the first, second and third. The first, this is a rotor and stator. So the stagnation pressure that improve, or we can say rise, occurs only in the rotor. But in practically we can say there will be some losses in the stator due to the fluid friction. Okay, this is the very important reason. So due to this reason, we can say the loss form, fluid friction. Okay, so which will result in decreasing stagnation pressure. Okay, so there are also some losses in rotor and the stagnation pressure rise that will be less than of an isentropic compression. So here, once we apply the thermodynamics law here, so here we use the internal energy, enthalpy, entropy, fine, and the temperature, pressure, velocity. So we can say these all are the air properties. These all are the aerodynamic properties. Fine. But this is very important. Velocity triangle. Okay. So what do you mean by velocity triangle? Okay. Here there are a lots of nomenclatures available that we can say W1, beta1, alpha1, C1, CA1, C theta 1, U. But what do you mean by it? Okay. So we will not discuss much more about the this nomenclature, but this is known as the alpha 1 is the angle between the axial velocity and absolute velocity. Okay, this is a relative velocity is known as the W1. Axial velocity is indicating CA1, then absolute velocity is indicated with CA1. So whatever the angle made is known as alpha 1 here, between this and this, and between axial velocity and relative velocity is known as the beta 1. Okay, this is known as the relative angle. And whatever the distance from here to here is known as C theta 1. Okay, so the physics from thermodynamics to aerodynamics, air particles simply move. And how? How the rotor and stator blade moves, that we can see in this image, it's continuously move on the shaft. Okay, so what happened? Rotor and stator. Stator is a fixed element and rotor is continuously moving. So what happened in rotor? This is the rotor shape. This is the rotor blade. This is the stator blade. So what happened? Here the rotor blade is continuously moving. Okay, so here particle of air travel from leading edge to trailing edge. So the air particles that's traveling radially, okay, so in axis, in axial direction as well as the radial direction. So with C1 and W1, fine. So using the velocity triangle, we can say here the angle is made between this and this, known as alpha 1 and beta 1. Okay, same way before the stator blade, whatever the air is coming from the IGB to rotor to stator. Okay, so here the inlet part and exit part both has a same angle, alpha 1 equal to alpha 3. Fine. And this is the full velocity triangle for the compressor stage. Fine. This is the entry velocity triangle. This is the exit velocity triangle. Fine. This is the axial velocity CX1, CX1, CX2, CX3. Fine. So we can say that the boundary layer behavior over the blade, this word is also very important in aerodynamics. Boundary layer. What do you mean by boundary layer? Okay, so as I told you, the flow passes over the airfoil, right? Whenever the particle of air that travel over the airfoil, so at that time we know that the solid surface and moving part is air. Moving part is rotor blade also. Okay, so continuously rotor is moving, continuously air particle is moving. So there are lots of friction between the air and solid object. Solid object here we are considering the rotor blade. Okay, so the physics of rotor and air, the physics of stator and air, both are changed. Okay, why? Because the angle is also changed. So boundary layer also very important. Physics over the airfoil, over the blade. Okay, so in x direction, in y direction, the boundary layer form, in x direction is also formed, in y direction is also formed, right? So if we are talking about the turbine, so turbine aerodynamics, that this blading design that accelerating the flow typically shuts down boundary layer growth and reduces the sensitivity to variation such as the upstream velocity flow field. Fine. And also the different aerodynamic design approaches in turbine blade rows, such as we can say the forward loaded versus the aft loaded blading, and that can still impact secondary flow and overall losses. Fine. So as I told you, there are lots of losses formed for the case of turbine, for the case of compressor. Fine. So the improved aerodynamic leads to increase the stage loading as well as the higher performance in turbine. So the same pressure ratio compressor is typically have a more stage than the turbine, right? So to be clear, even the turbine airfoil, where the flow is generally accelerating or at least not diffusing, fine, on a bulk basis from inlet to exit, so it might be have an area of local diffusion, and this perhaps in region of locally high curvature downstream of the passage throat, or we can say the off design, fine, we can say the off design condition, and that can even the area of local separation and reattachment over the case of turbine blade. But in general, the compressor airfoil, that designer deal with this issue that related to diffusing flow much more extensively than the turbine designer. Fine. So this turbine blade is complicated compared to axial fan blade as well as the compressor fan blade. Fine. So that here we can see the velocity triangle equations using the trigonometric relation. We can find it out all the values. Cx1 equal to C1 cos alpha 1 equal to W1 cos beta 1. So using the trigonometric relation, we can easily find it out all the equations, right? And we know that there are lots of airfoil available in airfoil tool. Fine. So based on our applications, we can choose any one. Okay. Now apply the velocity triangle physics over the blade, and finally we can make a blade, make an airfoil tube blade using the physics of velocity triangle. So it's a very complicated process. It's a very pen and paper. It's a very complicated process from airfoil to blade. Okay, so here we have an example of B2 fan. So this is the blade profile that presented in the form of radially stacked airfoil profile for the B2 fan. Okay, so what exactly in it? Here, from leading edge to trailing edge, this shape is formed using the velocity triangle, and finally we are attaching from first airfoil to end of this airfoil. So we can easily get the very nice curvature of blade. Okay, so once again, based on our applications, we have to find it out. Okay, now where we can apply the aerodynamic in turbo machines. So this is the intake, as we discussed earlier. This is the compressor part. So here there are lots of compressor stage in it, the combustions going on inside it, and this is the turbine stage. Fine. So, and finally the air exhaust with high temperature. Okay, so this is the advanced aerodynamic is used in fan, compressor and turbine. So what can be innovative in field of turbo machines? First, we will improve the fan blade. Okay, we can reduce or increase the diameter of the axial fan. This is the first one. Second is, we can change the shape of airfoil, apply the physics of velocity triangle over it, and make a proper blade with appropriate curvature. Okay, so this is the first innovative we can do it. Then after, compressor. Okay, so mainly Naka 65 series airfoils that uses in gas turbine engine, especially for the compression part. Okay, so we can also increase or decrease the distance of two rotor blades. Fine. As well as we can also improve the distance. We can also decrease or increase the distance between the rotor and stator blade. Okay, so same physics we can apply for the turbine blade. Okay, so using this R&D, we can improve the aerodynamic efficiency. Fine. This is the very important part, the wind turbine. Okay, so wind. So here, air particle is coming from this direction to through the this directions. Okay, so this blade is continuously moving. Suppose we will improve the shape of blade, so we can get maximum lift, we can get minimum drag, we can improve the aerodynamic efficiency using the ratio of CL by CD. That we can say the ratio of CL is nothing but coefficient of lift to coefficient of drag. Fine. So we can improve the aerodynamic efficiency, and using this physics, we can apply the aerodynamic property physics using the tool of ANSYS to find out pressure value, to find out velocity value, to reduce the drag, to improve the lift. But how? Using tool, we can easily do it. Fine. Here we can change the design of blade, we can change the shape of airfoil blade, and parallelly you can do the analysis. Okay, so finally you will conclude that suppose we will use which type of blade, we can improve the aerodynamic efficiency, we can change the thickness of airfoil blade, we can change the length of the blade, we can improve the diameter of fan blade. Fine. So using this technique, we can improve the efficiency. So this is the most appropriate example of wind turbine. Okay. And as we discussed here, the air axial flow directions, this is the nose cone. Okay. The fan drive is there. Here the fan blade is available here. This is a 2D image. Okay. Entry part, exit part. Okay. So we can apply the aerodynamic physics over it and improve the CL by CD, improve the coefficient of lift to drag ratio. Okay. And suppose we have to improve the solid casing. This is known as the casing part. Okay. Here, there are lots of treatment for the solid treatment, and there are lots of the treatment we can apply over it. Okay, so using this technique we can also find it out the aerodynamic efficiency, we can also change the angle of bell mouth, and we can find it out the efficiency. Okay, so there are lots of possibility available for the case of rotor blade axial fan. So once again, this is the physics of velocity triangle, and look at this. This is the combination of 2D and 3D with real life, real wind turbine. So velocity triangle is also a very important role in wind turbine, okay? Steam turbine. This is a turbine, okay? And this is the assemble of a turbine. This is the dismantle part of turbine. So look at this. We can here change the stator blade dimensions from hub to tip ratio. This is the casing. This is the shaft. That put it inside it. The rotor is continuously moving. Okay, the arrangement of turbine, right? And this is the casing part of this blade, and this is the covering. Okay, so we can play with the different airfoil, put it down here. We can play with the different solid casing treatment, and using the any tool, using the computational fluid dynamic physics, we can find it out the aerodynamic efficiency. So this is a very nice colorful image about the rotor and stator blade. So the, as I told you earlier, the flow arrives in the axial direction, the flow turns into the stator blade, then after once again the flow is turned back. So simply particle of air that travel from here to here. Okay. And we finally, as a result, we rise the pressure. Okay. So this is the rotation of rotor blade and stator blade. Right. So this is a two-dimensional image of turbine. This is very important. Where can you apply the aerodynamics? Okay. We can apply the aerodynamics of turbo machines. Right? But where? Wind turbine, compressor, and many of the applications like in aerospace engineering, but without physics of CFD, we cannot do aerodynamic analysis, we cannot do turbo machines analysis. So what do you mean by the computational fluid dynamics? This CFD, this computational fluid dynamic, is nothing but this is the physical problem of mathematical model as well as the experimental analysis, right? So physical problem is physical problem means analysis of physical problem in any area of engineering and science that involves in the multi-pronged approach, fine. So the idealized physical model that we can say that using the experimental technique, we can do it. The mathematical model means we can apply the theoretical analysis, or we can say the analytical solutions and approximate the numerical solutions, fine. So the physical experiments, numerical simulations, this is very important, right? Without it, we cannot find it out the computational fluid dynamics. So this computational fluid dynamic is nothing but that we can say the mathematical modeling of a continuum problem that leads to a set of differential, integral or integro-differential equations that exert the analytical solutions of such equation is limited to problems in simple geometry, fine. So this simple computational fluid dynamics for the thermofluid problem, this is very approach to popular known as the CFD. And this is a branch of continuum mechanics which deals with the numerical solution of fluid flow and heat transfer problem. So this computational fluid dynamics that deal with the approximate numerical. Okay. So in earlier, using the experimental technique, we can find it out the flow over a body case. But recently, but now what happened? Using the tool, using the CFD tool, we can easily find it out the aerodynamic properties. Fine. So this CFD technique is very important to find out all the properties, and by cost we can say. There are lots of applications of CFD that we can say the weather forecasting, we can say the flow passes over the aircraft to find out the aerodynamic efficiency, right? So to find out the flow over a object like this, okay, the flow over aircraft like this, and in sports aerodynamics we can say the flow over the golf ball as well as the smooth sphere, right? So once again, this word is very important, boundary layer, fine. So as we discussed, whenever this particle of air that travel over the smooth sphere, so what happened? The boundary layer form over it, okay? So exactly we don't know which type of boundary layer form. It's a laminar type or the turbulent type, right? Here the separation point is also formed near this area, fine. And we can say the turbulence or the wake region form at this thick wave, fine. So here the large wake of separated flow, it has a very high pressure drag, that laminar boundary layer, the separations point. Suppose if we are applying the physics aerodynamics over the golf ball, so what happens? So there are lots of dimples on it, okay. So we can improve the thick wave, okay, to reduce the size of wake of separated flow, we can say the low pressure drag, the turbulent boundary separation point, right? So this is the example of sports in aerodynamics. So using this technique, we can improve the boundary layer. We can minimize the drag, okay? So look at this. This is a computational fluid dynamic analysis over the golf ball, okay? So once again, this is the cricket ball, off spin, leg spin, the side spin, right? So top spin, under spin, the shuttlecock also there, okay? The flow of a vehicle in aerodynamics car, fine. So look at this. Here we have a different shape of the car like this. So if we compare 1, 2, and 3 image, so look at the trajectory or profile of air over it, fine. So this is a very big topic, vehicle aerodynamics and the racing bicycle, okay. So if we change the helmet shape, right? So what happened? Okay, so this is the comparison between it. The building aerodynamics, fine. Okay, so without aerodynamics, without CFD, without physics of turbo machines, we cannot gain the energy. We cannot improve the efficiency. Fine. Okay, so here, thank you very much. My session is over. The introductory portion of aerodynamics of turbo. So if you have any questions regarding it, you can ask me. And there are lots of R&Ds going on in turbo machinery field using the physics of aerodynamics.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, whatever.
Thank you very much, sir, providing such an immense knowledge to the students of Diploma Aeronautical Engineering. Really loved your session, sir. I would like to thank you on behalf of Karul University as well for sparing your valuable time for the students. As well as I would like to provide you the appreciation certificate, sir, on behalf of Karul University.
Yes, thank you. So if students have any questions, we have a more 10 to 15 minutes, so we'll discuss about it.
Yes, sir, I have sent the message for the same. If any questions comes, I will let you know.
Sure.
I mean, the screen is visible, sir?
Yes, it's visible.
Thank you. Starting your valuable knowledge and insights as an expert speaker during the webinar on the topic aerodynamics of turbo machines. We are grateful for your precious time and deep enlightenment.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Professor Kannel. It's a wonderful certificate. Very nice.
Sir, I think I'm not getting any questions from students, right?
Okay. So, shall we conclude?
Yes, sir. We can.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Have a great day.